The last panel generated a lot of interesting questions. I anticipate this one doing the same. There's no doubt in what we've heard, both from the challenges and what needs to be done, the physical energy infrastructure may change, but in order to for things to happen, it really depends upon individuals and institutions for that to occur. We haven't heard a lot about individuals and institutions. We will on this panel for sure hear about institutions and may hear about individuals, but I want to digress just a minute to talk about the program that John Randall mentioned briefly, the Alternative Energy Future, which started with the American Academy 8 years ago, to see how social and behavioral sciences could help promote and accelerate adoption of new energy technologies. And I also want to mention another key player in this, the late Bob Fry, who helped initiate this problem, who was another person who really worked in both the climate and the energy areas for decades. We all miss him. He passed away 3 years ago. He was an inspiration for this project. And just a little brief about his background. He was the first deputy administrator at EPA in 1970, and then he was the deputy administrator of the Energy Research and Development Administration in the mid-70s, and I had the privilege of working and learning from him at that point. Then from 1986 to 96, he was president of Resources for the Future, and sort of ties everything together. He went from there to being the director of the Smithsonian Institute for Natural History, sort of a real Renaissance person of a broad career to add to this. Well, the Alternative Energy Future Project began sort of an outgrowth of a PCAST study that was done in 2010 to see about accelerating the pace of change in energy technology. Ernie Moniz, who had to leave PCAST to become Secretary of Energy in the second Obama administration, and I had the privilege of co-chairing that study, and Bob was a member of the working group. And one of the main recommendations was that the Department of Energy and National Science Foundation should initiate a multidisciplinary social science research program that would provide critical information and support for policy development that advances the diffusion of technologies. After the report was issued, Bob and I met with Steve Koonin, who was at the time the Undersecretary for Science at DOE, and Cora Merritt, who was Deputy Director at National Science Foundation, and they funded the project, which began at that point. Been many products and workshops as a result of that. One of the first ones, which sort of laid an agenda, was Beyond Technology, Strengthening Energy Policy Through Social Science. That is, I assume, available on the website. And just to give an example of how social science can really make a difference, that OPower, which is now a subsidiary of Oracle, provides, and I know it, I get it in Los Angeles Water Power, I assume Southern California Edison does too, compares the energy use to that of its, what you're using with the neighbors. So through this simple and cost-effective sort of challenge to everybody, it's based on behavioral science by Bob Cialdini. And it's seen, there's been an average, and it's sustained itself over the last 5-6 years where it's been implemented, of a 2.5% reduction among residential consumers for that. The Department of Energy, about 4 or 5 years ago, adopted one of the recommendations that projects should have a social scientist on them. And solar energy program called SEEDS, Evolution and Diffusion Studies, which I think got started in about 2013 or 14, had seven teams that did have people from utilities and the social science community. They've also worked closely with New York State ERTA, which had a program, and I don't know, Robert, I didn't do ahead of time whether California at that time was in about 2-3 years ago thinking of having a social science program, whether that did proceed. Well, I think our panel is going to talk, have a very diverse panel of and different points of view. We'll be starting off with Robert Weisenmiller, who is the head of the California Energy Commission, and we talked earlier about how important a role it has played and how he and Mary do actually work together, that they do talk to one another. And that will be followed by Nate Lewis, who is really a visionary chemist and just one who really thinks out of the box. But the other thing that he says, one of the things he's most proud of, for 29 years he has taught the freshman chemistry course at Caltech. And so anybody who graduated in the past three decades has had the privilege of having Nate as a lecturer. And then we, Dallas Boutreau will talk about a project that's been funded by the Sloan Foundation to the American Academy that I mentioned earlier about looking at a policy that is both durable, adaptable, and reliable, and using the Clean Air Act as a change. He's our economist in the group. So the three of you will, as the last time, 10 minutes each, and then we'll have questions and answers.